Good morning, students. Today we will discuss exercise 8.2, question number 2. So see children, exercise 8.2, question number 2. ABCD is a rhombus and P, Q, R and S are the midpoints of the sides AB, BC, CD and DA respectively. Show that the quadrilateral PQRS is a rectangle. So see children, here in a given question, rhombus A, B, C, D is given to us. This is the rhombus A, B, C, D. It is given to us. Point P, point Q, point R and point S are the midpoints of the side AB, BC, CD and DA. AC and BD both are diagonals and they can intersect at point M. Now, P and Q be joined, Q and R be joined, R and S be joined, S and P joined. Then we can get quadrilateral PQRS. This quadrilateral PQRS. And this quadrilateral PQRS is the rectangle that we have to prove. So see children, quadrilateral ABCD is rhombus, P, Q, R and S are the midpoints of the side AB, BC, CD and DA respectively. That already we discussed. Now see children, in triangle ABC. So see children, in triangle ABC, in this triangle ABC, P and Q both are midpoint of AB and BC. So we can write PQ is parallel to AC and PQ is half of the AC. So see children, in triangle ABC, PQ parallel AC and PQ is equal to half of the AC. Now in triangle ADC, this triangle, S and R both are midpoint of AD and DC. So we can write SR parallel to AC, this SR parallel to AC and SR is half of the AC. So see children, in triangle ADC, SR parallel AC and SR is equal to half of the AC. Now see children, PQ is equal to half of the AC and SR is equal to also half of the AC. So indirectly, PQ is equal to SR or SR is equal to PQ. Also, PQ parallel to AC, SR parallel to AC. So, PQ is also parallel to SR. So, see children, in quadrilateral PQRS, in this quadrilateral PQRS, SR is parallel to PQ, SR is parallel to PQ and SR is equal to PQ. So, we can say that quadrilateral PQRS is the parallelogram. So in quadrilateral PQRS, SR parallel to PQ and SR is equal to PQ. So quadrilateral PQRS is the parallelogram. Now quadrilateral ABCD is rhombus. So see children, quadrilateral ABCD is rhombus. So diagonal AC and BD bisect at M. So this diagonal AC and diagonal BD, they can bisect at point M. So angle AMB, so this angle, so angle AMB is equal to 90 degree. So see children, now quadrilateral ABCD is rhombus, so diagonal AC and BD bisect at M, so angle AMN is equal to 90 degree. AMN or AMB both are same. So this angle AMN, here point N is available. So AMN is equal to 90 degree. Now see children, so angle AMN is equal to 90 degree. Now AC parallel PQ and MN is transversal. So see children, this AC is parallel to PQ and MN is transversal. So see children, angle AMN plus angle MNP is equal to 180 degree because they are co-interior angle. So see children, here AC parallel PQ and MN is transversal. So angle AMN and angle MNP, this angle and this angle, their sum is 180 degree because they are co-interior angle. So see children, here angle AMN plus angle MNP is equal to 180 degree because they are co-interior angle. But see children, angle AMN is equal to 90 degree. Angle AMN is equal to 90 degree and we proved this. Angle AMN plus angle MNP is equal to 180 degree. Now instead of angle AMN, we can write 90 degree because angle AMN is equal to 90 degree. So see, here 90 degree plus angle MNP is equal to 180 degree. Now 90 degree side we change, so on other side it become negative. So see, children, angle MNP is equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree, so it is 90 degree. Means angle MNP is equal to 90 degree. This angle MNP is equal to 90 degree. Now in triangle ABD, S and P are the midpoint of AB and AD respectively. Now in triangle ABD, see, this is the triangle ABD. P and S are the midpoint of AB and AD respectively. So we can write SP is parallel to DB. So see, children, now in triangle ABD, S and P are midpoint of AB and AD respectively. So PS parallel BD. So we can write PS parallel BD or SP parallel DB. So see, children, P and S both are midpoint of AB and AD respectively in triangle ADB. So PS parallel to BD. Now see, children, so PS parallel to BD and NP is the transversal. So see, this PS is parallel to BD and NP is the transversal. So angle MNP plus angle NPS is equal to 180 degree because they are co-interior angle. So angle MNP and angle NPS, this angle and this angle, both are co-interior angle. So their sum is 180 degree. So see, general, PS parallel BD and NP is transversal. PS is parallel to BD and this NP is the transversal. So MNP plus NPS is equal to 180 degree because they are co-interior angle. But angle MNP is equal to 90 degree. So instead of MNP, we can write 90 degree. See, here we proved angle MNP is equal to 90 degree. So angle MNP plus angle NPS is equal to 180 degree. Instead of MNP, we can write 90 degree. So 90 degree plus NPS is equal to 180 degree. So 90 degree side we change, so it become negative on other side of the equal. So angle NPS is equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree, so is equal to 90 degree. Means angle NPS is equal to 90 degree. So see, children, angle NPS, this angle is equal to 90 degree. Now angle NPS is equal to 90 degree, so angle QRS is equal to 90 degree. See, angle NPS is equal to 90 degree. So angle QRS is also 90 degree because NPS and QRS both are same only. So angle NPS is equal to 90 degree. So QPS is equal to 90 degree and angle QPS is equal to 90 degree. Then angle P is equal to also 90 degree. See, QPS is equal to 90 degree. So angle P is also 90 degree. So angle P is equal to 90 degree. Now, in parallelogram PQRS, one angle P is equal to 90 degree. So, all other angles is also 90 degree. So, in quadrilateral PQRS, one angle P is equal to 90 degree. So, other all angles measurement is also 90 degree. So, in quadrilateral PQRS, all angles are right. So, we can say that quadrilateral PQRS is the rectangle. In quadrilateral PQRS, all the angles measurement is 90 degree. So we can say that quadrilateral PQRS is the rectangle, and that we proved. So see, children, this is the explanation of exercise 8.2, question number 2. I hope you can understand this. Thank you.